Spiritual Analogies Number 2, You as a Company, written and narrated by T.J. Fairley. Generally speaking, each person is born with complete control over themselves in terms of what they will and will not do. Everyone has authority figures over them, but they have control over how they respond to that authority. In a sense, each of us owns ourselves much like a person may own a company. In other words, you own, quote, You, Inc. The company of You, Inc. incorporates your spirit, soul, and body. However, when we accept Jesus as our Savior and Lord, and we are therefore born again, it is like we have been, quote, bought out by God. He essentially buys the failing company of our life, and He desires to rehab it into a successful company for His purposes. This reality is reflected in the words of the Apostle Paul, who wrote by the inspiration of the Holy Spirit, "Don't you know that your body is a temple of the Holy Spirit, who is in you, whom you have from God? You are not your own, for you were bought with a price. Therefore, glorify God in your body and in your spirit, which are God's." 1 Corinthians 6, 19-20 in the WEB. Even though God owns us outright, the way God manages the company of, quote, You, Inc. is similar to a business that has a co-ownership set up with two primary owners. Although God is by far the more wise and experienced owner, in His amazing humility, God allows us to take as much controlling interest in the company as we decide. If we so choose, we can make our controlling interest 50-50, where we go with God's leading half of the time, but we make our own decisions the other half. We can make it 90%, 10%, where we make almost all of the decisions in our life, but on occasion we do what we perceive God wants. In fact, each day we can implement any percentage we want regarding how many decisions we control and how many times we yield to God's desires in us. As the perfect example of how we should handle the co-control of our lives, Jesus showed us how to yield 100% of our decisions to the Word of God and the leading of the Holy Spirit. In other words, God had complete controlling interest in, quote, Jesus, Inc. Whenever Jesus' desires conflicted with God's will, Jesus forwent His own desires. Jesus did this even when it was extremely hard for Him to do so. See Luke 22:42. Jesus yielding Himself to God fully allowed God to accomplish everything He wanted to accomplish through Jesus while Jesus was on the earth. Nevertheless, everything that needs to be done on earth concerning God's will could not be done just through Jesus by Himself. This is why the body of Christ is meant to carry on the work of Jesus. Yet, the body of Christ is made up of many individual members, each with controlling interest in their own lives. Therefore, God is looking for people who, just like Jesus, will yield themselves to His work and His will. See 2 Chronicles 16:9. When God finds such people, He can accomplish what He wants to through their life. Therefore, regardless of what the rest of the body does or does not do, those members who yield to God will be rewarded for allowing God to use them to accomplish His purposes on the earth. As the Word says, "For the body is not one part, but many. If the foot says, 'Because I am not a hand, I am not a part of the body,' it is not for this reason any less a part of the body. And if the ear says, 'Because I am not an eye, I am not a part of the body,' it is not for this reason any less a part of the body. If the whole body were an eye, where would the hearing be? If the whole body were hearing, where would the sense of smell be? But now God has arranged the parts, each one of them in the body, just as He desired. If they were all one part, where would the body be? But now there are many parts, but one body. And the eye cannot say to the hand, 'I have no need of you,' or again the head to the feet, 'I have no need of you.' On the contrary, It is much truer that the parts of the body which seem to be weaker are necessary, and those parts of the body which we consider less honorable, on these we bestow greater honor, and our less presentable parts become much more presentable. 1 Corinthians 12:14 through 23 in the NASB 2020. Each member of the body of Christ has a God-ordained plan attached to their life. If you are a member of the body, this includes you. We have no control over yesterday, and we do not know for sure what will happen tomorrow. The only question you have to involve yourself with is, how much controlling interest in your decisions will you give God today?